can't talk effectively about my mom's side of the family, even if I wanted to. So, I think I'll talk to you a little bit about my dad's side. '70s. I am talking about my stepmother's brother-in-law. He was a boy who had a wooden leg since he was 7 years old. Sister Marty. But the best single part about my Uncle Floyd, well, it wasn't his wooden leg, and it wasn't the fact that he chawed on straight Union Standard chaw. No, it wasn't. Or that he spat right in the spittoon in front of a whole goddamn fucking family. No. Another liberated man. He let my, well, I don't know if you let her, but he was involved in the decision for my Aunt Marty, my stepmother's sister Marty, to run for city council. The election. Thanks. Actually, there's one more thing. A lot of new people came, and I can't see you. I don't know if you're just here to eat or if you're here to see me, whatever the case is. I'm glad you came. My name is Beau Mansfield, and there is one little thing about Uncle Floyd, though, that is interesting beyond that. I couldn't figure out a way to put it in the song, but it's a true story, as was everything I put in the song. My Uncle Floyd, well, he was born and raised in Oklahoma, as was I, until I was 17 years old and moved to the East Coast after I graduated high school. But a few months after I graduated high school and had been living in the East Coast in New Jersey and came to visit New York at least once a week at that point, I went back home to visit for Christmas. And I saw my Uncle Floyd, and I hadn't exchanged three or four sentences with Uncle Floyd when all of a sudden he said to me, verbatim, "You can tell you've been in the East Coast 'cause you sound so nasal." I just wanted to tell you that.
All right.
Thanks. No. Yeah, right. Now I'm a wimp. I'm an East Coast guy completely. I could never kick Floyd's ass. Well, I wouldn't have the heart anyway because he was, you know, handicapped, for God's sake. But anyway. Sidewalk Cafe often supports people with their new writing exercises as songwriters. And a good way to hear that is on Monday nights on the open mics here that Lach, the manager and booker of the Sidewalks Entertainment here, runs. And, well, to give you an example, I haven't played the next song I'm going to play in front of anyone yet. I just wrote this song last night. It's really short, too. But, you know, just in the spirit of what we do here at Sidewalk, I think I'm going to do it for you. It's called, "I Just Wrote This Song Last Night." Just wrote this song last night. Hope you like it and it goes alright. But I don't have any lyrics, so I don't know what the hell to do. But seriously, folks, I'm going to do a song that Lach actually commissioned from me, as well as having commissioned a lot of other people. He wanted us to write a song about local East Village artist and visionary autocratic auteur Ron English. What he did was, they brought Ron English's paintings for everyone to look at, and told us to write a song during the week. And on the next Monday, those with a completed Ron English song would be given priority on the list. And needless to say, I wrote one. But there were also comic books that Ron English had devised that were given out for free as a further aid in the creative process. And that's all I have to say about it. This is a song I call "Thanks a Lot, Ron." There's this guy, Ron English, and he drew a comic strip. And when I read it, he took me on my own kind of memory trip. Girls in high school treated him just about the same as me. But in my case, nothing has changed as far as I can see. So I say, "Thanks a lot, you fucking asshole. You made me remember things I wanna forget. Maybe someday things will get better, but they sure as fuck haven't yet." Trap and paints paintings of Madonna and all that kind of crap. But even though I've got limited visual appreciation, with that one comic strip he kind of summed up my whole situation. So I say, "Thanks a lot, you fucking asshole. You made me remember things I want to forget. because it takes you away from yourself. What I need's a girl who's gonna take me off the back of the shelf. Sorry, Ron, but there ain't no room in my world for the likes of you. And oil on canvas can't do half the things that a loaded bomb can do. So I say, I can flock in, asshole, you made me remember things I wanna forget. Maybe someday things will get better, but they sure as fuck haven't yet. Let's try that ending again. Thanks a lot, you fucking asshole. You made me remember things I wanna forget. Maybe some of the things will get better, but they sure as fuck haven't yet. Okay. Thanks. The dangers of getting carried away with yourself. Well, how much time do I have left, Lenny?
A minute.
My supervisor at my day job, ladies and gentlemen, Tommy Haynes. Complete with asinine remarks. Characteristic as hell. Thanks, I got like 20, no, about 11 minutes. That's cool. Okay, so, well. April? Where's sinking it, man? That's a little inside joke for the people. Well, is he here? See, now, he said that I had to sing the theme to the toilet that I wrote if he came, and I'm not going to do it just because you're here. Sorry. You want me to sing the goddamn theme to the toilet? All right. Everybody knows me. If you don't know me, I wrote this song I wrote the music. The director of a show that I was involved in called The Toilet, a comedy that was given down at Surf Reality, a guy named Noel Dowd directed it, and he wrote these lyrics. And it's basically three loser guys, an aging rock star, nerdy yuppie, and worthless layabout, played by April's friend Jeff Kenny. And he really liked the theme song. So what the fuck? I'll play it.
Do it!
It's so hard to get out of bed. I've nothing to do and nowhere to go. I'm all alone. My roommate is gone. And I've unplugged the phone. Birds trying to get ahead, providing online services, drinking too much and generally abusing one's body. Life is just a crapshoot. High rollers and low ballers, drinking too much and complaining about lost opportunities. That's why I'm a misanthropic, alcoholic, rock and rolling, couch potato, vegetating dude. Flushing it all down the toilet! Thanks. Yeah! Well.
Rock it!
Well, alright,
folks. Hi, Andrea.
Hi, okay.
Hi, whoever you were. Okay. Well, I work in Soho, and like 10 people here work with me in Soho.
Yeah. Yeah.
Give it up for the people I've got to face tomorrow at my day job. After humiliating myself thoroughly like I'm doing right now. And I'm not talking about the lack of musical talent. No, I'm talking about the fact that when I play for you people. I usually reveal the nerdiest possible aspects of my personality. I don't know why I do this exactly. It's just something that seems to come naturally. So I figure, why mess with success? Even though the success is highly qualified. As I was saying before, I got off of what I was saying before.
What were you saying before?
I was saying that I work in Soho, and, well, what I have to say about Soho is this. The supposedly post-pubescent girls walking up and down Broadway. And they look to me like pale Rwandans with $100 clothing. And all I want to ask you is, lips across just about any kind of breasts, but I'm telling you, these anorexic wonders are driving me out of my fucking mind. What happened to racks? What happened to ass? What happened? Oh my God, they're losing their, oh man, they're losing whatever they had to offer. For one more song, or for you to tell the audience something, Lenny. Something about the lines of both of them. Tell them what you have to tell them, Lenny. Ladies and gentlemen, the MC and host of tonight's festivities, Lenny Molotov, excellent songer and singwriter.
Yes, that's Beau Mansfield, man. You might have noticed there's not a cover here at the sidewalk. We can pay our musicians. I gotta get the rhythm on this one. We can pay our musicians with what you put in the tip jar. So please be generous when I come by. Bro's gonna do one more tune.
Thanks, Lenny. Well, this is pretty much gonna be the end of the show. And the next time I do a gig here, I plan to do all songs, and I'll probably have a backup band. The last gig I did here, I had a backup band. This time I thought I'd try something different. I'd just do me and do what I'm sort of more well known for at the open mics, which is my improvisation, like this. Sidewalk scene here, besides Lenny and John Berger.
Yeah!
How's it going, John? I'm glad you came to see me. I know you're here all the time, but that doesn't matter to me. Your presence still counts, I assure you. People ask. musician, or am I a comedian, or am I a musician slash comedian? Well, the answer is quite obvious. I'm whatever gets me the most cash and pussy. I appreciate your presence here this evening, and I would love to put you on a mailing list if you'd so desire at the end, which is now. Bye! Yeah. Thanks for coming. I appreciate it. Bye-bye.
Stick around, y'all. We're going to have Peter Dizozza and his crew come up in about 2 minutes. Let's hear it one more time for Beau Mansfield.
Yeah, that's all right. Thanks for coming. If there had only been like stations like Dery or I was thinking in my head from like an imaginary audience of like three people who don't know, and then they would like think that and be like, this is this guy, like
I really appreciate it.
Here's what he does.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have your attention. We're moving right along here. We have our second act up on piano night. I'll take care of it. I just like the power of having you up here with a microphone and not being able to do anything. So ladies and gentlemen, let's give a warm sidewalk welcome to a fixture around here, one of the coolest singer-songwriters. Let's give it up for Peter Dizozza.
Case closed. Case closed. I knew I loved you from the get-go. If I love you, then I love you till I die. I have a reason. Yeah, no reason saying why. I'll always love you. The depth of love is pure. I'll always love you. I'll never need to cure it until now. Let's go from there. Wash off this dirt. Oh, told me it's okay. Whenever we're together in the farmhouse, hey, living is easy if we stayed on terms. No need to talk, gotta wash off these germs. Someone told me it was okay. Just like a quart of Daniels in the farmhouse, hey, living is easy in the country climb. I'll always love you, gonna love you for all time. Moment, calling everyone I know. Don't on my own. Well, where do I go when my life is low and the four winds blow me around? That's when I stop, think of a quiet moment. Stop, what have I found? Pardon me, sir, but you look familiar. Your features stir and astound. Didn't you stop during the quiet moment? Stop, what have you found? Inner light, the flickering is ever so bright. With other lights that blaze nearby, it isn't so bright. A wealth of goods hides in one bag. Screaming, bathing beauties, bang on the door. They bash it down in their lust for more. They're gonna leave you lying on the bathroom floor. Pardon me, sir, but you look familiar. Your features stir and astound. Didn't you stop during the quiet moment? Stop, what have you found? To breed psychosis. I'm behind that monster vehicle, imagining my fantasy girl wrapped in the pulsing white lines of the four-lane highway as her image appears double exposed, sprawled like a patient, etherized across the night sky. I drive by night.
I drive by night.
I sleep by day.
I sleep by day. Yeah.
daughters must be taken care of. I know they'll understand my love. I know they'll understand my love. I got it right, they've got it right where I need it. And I will fight to keep my welterweight line. I try by night and make my bed in the daylight. That's right, that's right, that's right. Transport, get to the hotel and crash. I got them blues, I got the coffin stiffness and constraining. I got this package growing, I know it's all containing. I got it right, it got me right where I'm needed. And I will fight to keep my welterweight line. And drive by night, get my bed in the daylight. That's right, that's right, that's right. I'm in my dream. Sent to Earth to learn a lesson in peace providing. That's what the peace mission is about. Oh, thanks, Erica. And in this song, there are two Earth boys. They cannot only feel the coming of the alien presence, but they even anticipate the withdrawal that they will suffer when the aliens leave them. And here to sing with me is the great songwriter entertainer Charles Herrold. We're playing. It's two Earth boys. Anticipating the aliens. Oh, okay. It's called. Someone's coming. Hi, Charles.
Running from instead
of going well. bothers
in your name.
Collapse until we're harmless. Now you're safe.
Now you're safe.
On your separate,
distant plane.
And still we go where the road will lead us. And yet we're wandering now. As we get near to the time, you get to beat us. Though you do not need to step on us. You're gonna step on us anyhow. We're the chosen people.
Called Life of Phobia, and it's by a great songwriter, Steve Espinola.
You lie alone in your bed again, hooked up to your oxygen. Your family's in the living room, they're getting on with their lives. And you don't doubt that they love you. The words are getting mighty few. A tired out part of them must wish you'd hurry up and die. And they'll watch baseball games next spring when you've lost everything. When you've lost everything. Oh yeah, oh yeah. And cause will change a new song they'll sing when you've lost. Lost everything, oh yeah, oh yeah. Dying slow's an awkward thing. Your friends aren't sure what they should bring. And conversation's harder when it's got no place to go. They try to time goodbyes just right, but you keep living night after night. They stand around afraid to eat your last pistachio.
Between Doe and Chee, between Beau and Peep, Guinea and Pig, it's Nettles and Applewhite until we meet in space.
Everything's fine in the throes of oblivion. Here we are, far from the places we've been. And from the sky comes a sign we are looking for. Universe, follow the sign to the ends of the earth. Then go in love if we love it all. all, everyone's fine. Everyone's fine in the throes of passion. Everyone into the one great notion. Everyone's been in a different surface until we meet in space. Everyone's fine in the throes of oblivion. Energy flows on the spiral within. We heed the call, all aboard for the fireball. Everyone's into the throes of passion. Everyone into the one great notion. Everyone's been on a different surface until we meet in space.
This is the song, if you saw the show, you know that it follows the carnage in an undertaker's home. It's caused by the unauthorized screening of the movie Alien. And the only people remaining alive after that movie is shown are Cemeteria. Cemeteria and Quasimodo. Here to sing the song is its co-writer, Lisa Dery. Welcoming her back to the sidewalk. See her briefly this before.
Their jobs, the problems their friends had, the taxes
spring such as it's been will soon be gone. And we'll be doing, let's see, here's a place to go. If it's in Bobby Rydell's great follow-up to I'm a Real Wild One and I Like to Have Fun. It's the Teen Beach Motel Haven between Atlantic City and Cape May. It's Wildwood. Spring will soon be gone. Summer's coming on. Now they're dreaming of lots of summer love. All to think about after school is out. Heading down the shore. Have a ball once more. Whoa, 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 whoa. Those wild days. Wild, wild, wild days. Oh, baby. Every day's a holiday. And every night is Saturday night. Oh, those wild days.
Jar for Peter Dizozza and his crew. Please be generous when I come by. Pete's going to do another song for us.
Huh. Thank you, Dan Emery, for taking the time out from the Mystery Band CD that he's making with Steve Espinola and to Charles Herrold, taking time out. Thank you also Erica Bell and Lisa Dery. Thank you Lenny Molotov for Lights and Sound and for Lach for having us here for the piano night. Stay tuned for the other great piano player, Steve Espinola. We've got Lee Feldman coming up, and then Allison Jalakour. Next will be Steve Espinola. I'm Peter Dizozza. Thank you again. Okay, I'm going to end with this. Insightful sounds, these voices need to confide in me. They're inching toward me like a sword in chest. They're coming inside of me. I have no choice when they're guiding me. They cheat, they steal, and they lie to me. Why do they hide in me? I say, let me be. With stealth I rise like heat off pavement. Stones, stones, jockeys are riding me. I hear their yells, the clang of bells, their sharp and spurs have been chiding me. Their jabs go under the hide of me. They urge me, be what you wanna be, do what you with me. I say, let me be. Be with you in a prison cell. Before you down a wishing well. You wanna be what you wanna be. Come on and do what you want with me. I'll let me be with you in a prison cell. Me for you, who I know so well. Be what you wanna be. Ooh, come on and do what you want with me.
Yeah. how many people said what's happened to your kids. Oh, wait. Never mind. I think I've never passed so many people.
I would go, if I were you,
look, I'm fine. Look, Sparks, you have, it's just like living in
Puerto Rico. Lose this.
It's like a subway, 3 minutes subway ride.
They're very smart and cool. Very smart and cool. Perfect for like, you know,
step right out. Step right out. And of course, it makes me so trustworthy.
So bad.
I mean, they're always getting taken in by
the
information.
Was it really?
No fucking way. Thank you for the suggestion. As long as I know you're into my
shit. I tried so many times to save it.
Save it exactly from
itself. That's why I told you about the singing.
What?
You didn't.
I don't know what you mean by
the singing. Can I yell that?
Tell us about it.
That's okay.
Jeans hurt, no.
I don't know anything.
Dan, Emery, and this week are playing.
Would you wrap it?
Oh, I literally didn't hear they're playing tonight. We don't know where it is, but if you happen to walk by,
that's what it says.
I got
to know Saturday morning.
I mean, it was a little bit.
Well, I know. No, I got it today. I checked it Sunday morning.
I'm ready to go. Oh, shoot. What's that?
Anyway,
the
project
got
very
successful.
He's around
and
he's
back there. Yeah.
He's
going
to be in
Dery
this weekend.
And it was interesting. No one was meeting the people. Until Steve kept saying, okay, all the bites.
It's very particular.
One bite.
Jesus.
Really long.
I've seen that note.
Who was there?
I think it is that. Maybe it's another one.
Well, it's too bad. But I thought her argument was interesting. Her argument was keep doing
it. Ladies and gentlemen, your feedback night, I mean, piano night. We're moving right along, and our next act is one of my favorite singer-songwriter pianists. And please stand by, we are going to deal with this feedback problem. He's one of the best singer-songwriters around, he's one of the coolest pianists around, and he's a personal friend of Chuck Berry. Let's give a warm sidewalk welcome to Steve Espinola.
Yeah. Ooh, ooh. Well, I know that you'll never fall in love with me, but I run back to you just the same. Goes to show, puppy love has got a hold on me. I'm the one, only one I can blame. Intoxicating in your time of need, and as a full-grown fox sound, I'm a big zero. Try to catch you, but I can't succeed. Try so hard to convince you I'm no a rare breed, and I'm a lovesick puppy dog, woof, woof, woof. Lovesick puppy dog, woof, 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 woof. Brown-eyed, bushy-tailed, woof, woof, woof. Lovesick puppy dog, woof, 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 woof. Shock, he's your little toy poodle. You pamper him, lie him on your lap. You pat his head and feed him your strudel. I get nothing but the table scraps. While I'm waiting out in the doghouse, look at your feet when you take your naps. And I'm a lovesick puppy dog, woof, woof, woof. Lovesick puppy dog, woof, 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 woof. Brown-eyed, bushy-tailed, woof, woof, woof. Lovesick puppy dog, woof, 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 woof. Uh-huh. Songs by other people who play here. I'm gonna do some of my own too. Some people gave me a couple requests, but I just felt like this would be kind of a fun, different kind of thing to do. I'm even gonna do one by the guy who you just heard, but I don't have to do that right away. This is a song by Marianne Farley. Place here has an incredible album called Daddy's Little Girl that everyone should get because it's really, 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 really good. But this isn't on that album, it's newer than that. Okay. It's called About You.
I stay my
position, a declaration of indecision. But every single word I say is true. Yeah. Feeling like I can't buy, I can't steal. That's how I feel about you. Every day I state my case, my words flying all over the place. But everything they say is true. That's how I feel about you. That's how I feel about you. Every day I'm taking my stand on a pulpit built upon quicksand, and every single word I say is true. That's how I feel about you. That's how I feel about you. Other people do them better than I do them, but it's just, I want to do them, so, you know, there it is. Alright, here's another new one of mine. Ready? Maybe not, because Forget that. Where's Dan? Is Dan here? Dan, let's do a couple songs. Yeah. I can move that mic somewhere. Yeah, you can sing it. Yeah. All right, someone requested that I do this one. This is another one of mine, but this isn't mine.
You're all right.
I say, more power to ya. Keep on kissing. Right out in the street. Right out in the street. Right out. Right out. Right out. Right out. Right out in the street. Right out in the street. Right out. Right out. Right out. Right out. Well, I love watching people who are talking to themselves. Talking to themselves right out in the street. And when I see someone who is really going for it, who can give me a conspiracy theory more complicated than the Bible that includes every single name in the Brooklyn telephone directory, I say, more power to ya. Figure it out for all of us. Right out in the street. Right out in the street. Right out. Right out. Right out. Right out. Well, I love watching kids who are out playing hooky. Out playing hooky right out in the street. And when I see someone who is really going for it, walking around, no, strutting his stuff, waving what may be an unlit joint in everyone's faces, I say, more power to ya. School sucks, man. Right out in the street. Right out in the street. Right out. Right out. Watching people who are singing for spare change, singing for spare change right out in the street. And when I see someone who is really going for it, singing her heart out like this. there's no tomorrow, and like there's infinite pain and no such thing as sorrow. I give her all my money and I say, more power to ya. Sing it, sister. Right out in the street, right out in the street, right out, right out, right out, right out. Watching people who are pissing in public, right out in the street. And when I see someone who is really going for it, writing his name in puddles on the pavement, shaking that shang-a-lang or leaving it dangling, or if some ostrich-like woman makes a really dramatic squat, I say, more power to you, piss me a river. Right out in the street, right out in the street, right out, right out, right out, right out, right out in the street. Watching people who are totally amazing looking right out in the street. And when I see someone who is really going for it, criminally gorgeous or outrageously ugly, walking around like the linchpin of the whole entire universe, I say, ooh, baby. Right out in the street, right out in the street, right out, right out, right out. Well, I love watching people who have no sense of humor, no sense of humor, right out in the street. And when I see someone who is really going for it, radiantly this incredibly corrosive music misery, I say, more power to ya. Frown, 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 right out in the street, right out in the street, right out, right out, right out, right out. Here comes the scary part, I love walking by after a terrible accident. In the middle of the street. And though I may feel for the families of the accident victims, and I may feel kind of sad, kind of nauseous, kind of terrified, I also feel more alive than any other time. So I say, more power to ya. Bleed, bleed, bleed. Right out in the street, right out in the street, right out, right out, right out. Here comes the wrap up. Here we go now. Couples who are kissing in public, right out in the street. And when I see a couple who are really going for it, kissing in public while pissing in public, while talking to themselves, while singing for spare change, while totally amazing looking, no sense of humor, and running around dancing, all kinds of crazy stuff, in a terrible accident, I write them a check for 1 million more power to yous right there on the spot. Right out in the street, right out in the street, right out, right out, right out, right out, right out, right out in the street, right out in the street, right out, right out, right out, right out. Hey, this is a song of dance. I'm singing it. Song of dance. I was up till 4 in the morning recording overdubs for Dan's album, which is going to be really good. For some reason, this one's not on it. Maybe it'll be on the next one. I feel like something is going wrong, and I love the girl, and I've been working hard, but every day just seems so long. I hold her every night, the morning, we just get up and walk away. And when we kiss our lips goodbye, it's not enough. It's not enough. It's just not enough. It's not enough to be in love. Something to call some your own. Say, just say that the answer must come from within. But if you're looking for it in her eyes, you better look again, cause it's not enough to be in love. She's been feeling down. She says she feels dissatisfied. She says she needs an answer. She says she needs a project. She needs some meaning in her life. She comes home tired from the real world and wonders what she's working for. Someone, you still need something to call your own. So just say that the answer must come from within. And if you're looking for in my eyes, you better look again. Cause it's not enough to be.
Yeah! Dan Emery song. Is sport here? Can I see? Something you all don't know. It's this guy I met on the internet, believe it or not. It wasn't like a chat room or sex thing or anything. We're both just really into this songwriter named Biff Rose. He's this crazy, brilliant, genius guy. And so, sort of found each other as I run this Biff Rose with me. And this is a song, he sent me this song. Sent me a tape of the songs, and this just song is just so freaking great. I've never played it though, I just decided right before I came here that I was going to play this. So this could be a total disaster. Let's try it, why not? It's called The Night Surrounds. Kettles will be whistling to proclaim with shrill insistence an impending cup of Sanka. Someone will be hearing and presumably enjoying something written by Paul Anka. Dogs will be forsaken and taken to the pound on the day they lay their body in the ground. A rock band will be praying for that single A&R guy who appreciates true genius. Someone with love will cling to someone who's already leaving. I hope nothing comes between us. Flags the wide world over will fly high atop the mast.
when that day comes to pass. Smirking here inside our nervous breakdown, shaking while the lucky planet sleeps. Night retreats, I swear it does. It can't stay dark for keeps. So let's go out and act as if it's Saturday. I can't bear to wait till one really arrives. A night retreats, a night returns, a night surrounds our lives. Arguments will rage between committed individuals about substantial issues. In a thousand teenage bedrooms, human passion will erupt into a thousand Kleenex tissues. Bats will keep careening round their echoes in their caves. On the day they lower you into your grave, come on with me, go walk you wander to a quiet place. An antidote to all this empty noise you've thrown up in our frenzy to deny each other's voice. Just for fun, we'll sing a little symphony. And just for once, not care if it survives. The night retreats, the night returns, the night surrounds our lives.
By a guy named Michael Murphy, or Sport Murphy. He used to have this band called the Skells, which I never saw. I don't know. Anyway, I just thought that was a freaking great song.
Hi.
More songs? Shit. All right. What am I going to do? I'm going to do a song by the guy who's going to perform me. For variety, you want to sing? Lisa Dery is going to sing on it, too. We've never, ever played this together, so... I don't remember what's your part and what's mine, we'll just have to... Oh great, and Peter even has it. This one's called Two Lovers, or something like that. Is that what it's called? I'm having so much fun, this is so fun to do other people's songs. I have it here, but if you, that's for you. Can I give two more one that's about like 15 seconds long? Can you deal with 15 seconds long? Okay, I think I'm gonna sneak up with 15 seconds. I don't know, but he doesn't know that yet. Our thoughts that burden us unload, two lovers on. No one can call us on the phone.
We're silent as a stone.
We trust what fortune has in store.
For lovers solid to the core.
We're off to run a new race.
The ones that we embrace.
They're the ones we never hear about again. They mean us well, but we know secrets lovers never tell. That's why we say we're off.
And there's no trace of us.
We're off.
And like a touring bus.
We're off.
And
thought of love when none is here to call their own. And so they think the thought of love alone.
What's your pleasure?
They choose to leave it flat and punctuate the end. We're just friends and that's all for now. Of thoughts that burden us unload, two lovers on tomorrow's road. We're off to run a new race. The ones that we embrace are the ones we never hear about again. They mean us well, but we know secrets lovers never tell. We know the precious secrets all too well. That's why we say we know the secrets lovers never tell. Yeah, Peter Dizozza song.
Yeah!
Yeah, all right, I'm singing this in. This is a song that Charles Herrold wrote. It's supposedly... Oh. Uh-oh, he's gonna... Okay, tip jar, here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna be passing on the tip jar. You know what that means, you know what to do.
Yeah, that's great. It means give me money. So I can pay royalties to the people. These songs are dumb. All right. This one's really, really quick. It's a Charles Herrold song that he wrote in my style, supposedly, and I agree. I kind of wish I'd written it.
Here he is. Spotlight.
And then this is a tennis racket. It's on a paddleball. That's Charles Herrold, that guy there. You should come to his goddamn show so he doesn't stop performing. He just put out like a performance suicide note in the last Any Matters saying he's never gonna play again. He didn't even say that part. You treat me so bad, you treat me so mean, you're the evilest person that I've ever seen. You should treat me better than you do, cause I'm the only person in this world who can stand you. There we go. Charles Herrold. I think this sounds a lot more melodic than that. All right, okay. Now here's the real last song. Tennis racket song. This song's by Mark Humble.
Yeah!
He's a guy who like plays here. No one ever comes to see him. He's great. Really, come to see this guy. So this one is, it's called like One More Kiss Goodbye or something. Sorry I have all these words in front of me, but I don't know these songs well enough to do. You know, I was realizing that like, it seems like all these songs are really like, maybe all good songs have like either desire or frustration in them, or usually like some combination of both. It's like, I read some writer who said all good songs are either fuck me or fuck you. So, this one, I don't know, this one's, I guess, more fuck me, but it has a little fuck in it. Mark Humble, so come to see this guy. Good things always come to those who wait. Since you kept me waiting for you, things have been great. Friends keep paying for my beers. They haven't been this poor in years. Don't give up was what I learned in school. Now you say there's one exception to every rule. Tell me why you have to be the one who means so much to me. You're making me blind. The way you keep changing your mind. It's the good news followed by goodbye. time I try. One more kiss goodbye. How long were we dreaming on our feet? Sleepwalking inside a bubble. The air was sweet. One more pair of reckless lovers, bound and gagged beneath the covers. Playing doctor was our favorite game. Till the x-rays came out backwards. Oh, what a shame.
The hell does that mean? I don't know.
Love was like a diamond shell. And now even Mark Humble doesn't know what he's talking about. I'm all alone with a doubt. It's the good news followed by goodbye. Every time I try, one more kiss goodbye. Say it wasn't raining anyway, so round and round and round the story goes. Everybody's got an answer, nobody knows. Swore to God this time was real, took a ride inside the wheel of infinite size. Swinging on sweet lullabies. It's the good news followed by goodbye. Every time I try, one more kiss
time. I was going to do a Lach song and a Dina Dean song, but I'll do that next time. Thanks, y'all, very much.
Stick around, y'all. We're going to have Andru McCann up in about 30 seconds. So let's hear it one more time for Steve Espinola.
All up here.
Gentlemen, something is important happening. We're having right now on the stage before you the improbable and wonderful and phenomenal Andru McCann.
Yes, my name's Andru McCann, and I'm the anti-cocktail lounge, act. And if you want to know what that means, I'll just stick around for half an hour. And then Lenny can put a little bit of reverb on this microphone, and then I can... Then I can sound not like that. I want to sound like Johnny Mathis. Look at me. I'm as helpless as a kitten of a tree. You like that? Okay. And yeah, I'm not even started yet. Wait, stick around, baby. Anyway. I'm a serious musician. My name's Andru McCann, as Lenny just said, and I am the Messiah. So far, so good.
Hi, Shakti. How you doing?
I feel good. I got friends here.
I know the secrets of this universe is true. And I have a knowledge and a wisdom here for you. So why don't you believe and put your faith in me? You'd be surprised to find that I'm so heavenly. I'm the Messiah. Follow me. I'm
a very holy man.
Don't you agree? It's a miracle that I even wrote down this song. I'm not blaspheming, cause I know I am the best. And if you think I'm lying, why don't you put me to the test? Cause I'm the Messiah. Follow me.
I'm a very holy man.
Don't you agree?
I missed that up. Please forgive me. I'm not really a piano player, as if I am. I can get a fucking thing out of it, baby. What do you think about that? I've been there.
I am the one who's gonna change your dreary life. Just give me all your money and you will feel alright. And later on, when there's nothing left for me or you, we all commit suicide, cause that's the thing to do. I'm the Messiah. Follow me. Holy man, don't you worry. I'm the Messiah. I'm not a liar. I'm the Messiah. I'm a holy man, a holy roller man. I'm a soul man. I'm the Messiah. I'm the Messiah. Are you the Messiah? I'm the Messiah. Thank you. That's the best. It's only a song. Anyone might take it literally. I'm out of breath already. So, anyway, did anybody come down 8th Street on the way down to the Sidewalk Cafe tonight? Did anybody come down 8th Street? No? Nobody walked down 8th Street. Did anybody walk down 8th Street at all today? We have one here. Well, this song is, yeah, thank you. It's for you, all of you. Maybe I should get a warning just in case, just as a backup. It's a very casual one, right?
I'm sick and tired of walking down 8th Street. I need a change of scenery. I'm gonna make a change in my life. Then maybe I will be happy. Instead, I'm gonna walk down 7th Street. I don't care if it's right or wrong. And you can tell my friends on 8th Street. We never, ever, ever didn't get along. You might be sad that you won't see me, but I don't blame you if you cry. But don't you worry, cause it's easy to no longer be a pacifier. Especially now here on the east side. Cause when I see the Kmart and the Gap on 8th Street, I know my neighborhood is dying. I'm the one who needs some. But when I
see those red uniforms, street sweepers sweeping up. I have to ask God, what have I done? It's time to say goodbye to West Street. I'm never gonna walk down there unless I'm gonna get excused. You'll have to get along without me. So goodbye, Street. What's the use? It's time to let you go. A mass produce.
Goodbye, Street. Goodbye. For those that have, I can see the, those are the people in the back, they can see the other people, not let alone me. Anyway, this is the Sidewalk Cafe, thank you very much for coming down. Now, this is the home of the Antifolk movement. And the Antifolk movement, not many people know what Antifolk means. It's like a personal experience. So, I'd like to give you my version of anti-folk.
How many beans in a hand can a bean? How many beans in a can? How many beans in a hand can a bean?
Is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
That was it. Hey. Was that funny enough? I mean, you know, I had a little ripple. There's a message here. Beth called Judy. Whoever that is. No. No, I'm going to play a story about the story of my life. Both of them are interested. I've been here in the Lower East Side for about 17, maybe 18 years. But this is the story. I've been living down the Lower East Side. And I was thinking of all those things that I tried.
You know, those things that you try.
But it's no good when all your dreams have died.
But I'm not quit yet till they bury me in the Lower East Side. I met an angel flying down the Nazi. She looked pretty, so I gave her a smile. She was my angel, to whom I took a